Objectives of this lecture is to understand physiological anatomy of stomach, composition and functions of gastric juice, mechanism of secretion of gastric juice, and regulation of the secretion of the gastric juice. In the next lecture, I will give you more information about the regulation of gastric motility and emptying and the applied aspect related to physiology of stomach. So let us begin. External features or gross features of the stomach. So grossly, stomach can be divided into five parts: fundus, cardia, body, pyloric entrum, and pyloric canal. Fundus is a dome-shaped portion of the stomach proximal to the opening of the esophagus inside the stomach. Cardia is the portion of the stomach near the opening of the esophagus or near the lower esophageal sphincter. Body is the portion of the stomach left to the angular notch and the cardia. Pyloric entrum is the portion of the stomach between the incisura angularis and the pyloric canal. And pyloric canal is the distal tubular part of the stomach. Internal features of the stomach. Stomach, like the other gastrointestinal organ, it contains various layers like the mucosa, submucosa, muscularis externa, as well as the outermost, that is the serosa. Here we can see the structural arrangement of the muscle inside the muscularis externa. So it contains outer longitudinal muscle layer, inner circular layer, and the innermost oblique muscle layer. This oblique muscle layer, it gradually fuses with the circular muscle layer near the entrum of the stomach, and it is responsible for the length of the lesser curvature of stomach. Stomach and duodenum, they are separated by thick circular smooth muscle layer, which is known as pyloric sphincter, and each muscle layer forms functional syncytium. The mucous membrane of the stomach, or the innermost layer of the stomach, it is thick and thrown into large folds. So here we can see this large fold present inside the mucosa of the stomach, and it is known as gastric ruga. Now this mucosa of the stomach, it is punctured by millions of gastric foveola or the gastric pits, which lead to the mucosal glands. In this figure, we can see external features of the stomach and internal features of the stomach. External features of the stomach, these are the various regions of the stomach like fundus, cardia, body of the stomach, entrum, and pylorus. And internal structures which are present in the gastric wall, this is the presence of the mucosa, submucosa, muscle layer, and the serosa. Mucosa of the stomach wall, it is thrown into the folds, which is known as ruga. And in the mucosa, there are small openings through which gastric glands, they open inside the lumen of the stomach. These are known as gastric pits or foveola. Here in this figure, we can see the microscopic picture of the gastric wall containing mucosa and the submucosa. Mucosa contains small openings, they are also known as gastric pits, through which gastric glands, they open inside the gastric lumen. And the muscularis mucosa, which is present between the mucosa and the submucosa. Here we can see various gastric glands, and the gastric glands in its lumen, it contains different type of the cells like surface mucus cell and the mucus neck cells, which secrete mucus, parietal cells, which contains numerous mitochondria, as well as the endoplasmic reticulum, which mainly secrete hydrochloric acid as well as the intrinsic factor. Chief cells, they secrete pepsinogen and gastric lipase, and G cells, they secrete the hormone gastrin. Now the distribution of these cells, they are different in the different part of the stomach. Gastric mucous membrane contains three types of the gastric glands: main gastric glands, cardiac tubular glands, and the pyloric or enteral glands, depending on the part of the stomach where they are situated. Main gastric glands, they are present in the body as well as the fundus of the stomach, and they mainly contain parietal cells, chief cell, and the enterochromaffin cells. Parietal cells, they secrete hydrochloric acid and intrinsic factor in the lumen of the stomach. Chief cells or peptic cell, they secrete pepsinogen 1 and gastric lipase, and enterochromaffin cells, they mainly secrete histamine in the lumen of the stomach. Cardiac tubular glands, they are situated near the cardia of the stomach, and they mainly secrete mucin. Pyloric and enteral glands. They are situated in the enterum as well as the pylorus of the stomach, and they contain G cell. They mainly secrete gastrin, and they also contain various mucus cells. They secrete mucus inside the lumen of the stomach. Functions of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid, it is secreted by parietal cell or the oxyntic cell in the lumen of the stomach. Hydrochloric acid, it provides hydrogen ion concentration for the optimum pepsin activity. It activates pepsinogen and converts pepsinogen to pepsin and prosecretin to secretin. Hydrochloric acid kills ingested bacteria, so it is bactericidal in nature. It helps in the absorption of the iron by conversion of the Fe plus 3 to Fe plus 2, which can be absorbed. So, decrease in the secretion of the HCl in stomach, it can lead to iron deficiency anemia because of the decreased absorption of iron. Hydrochloric acid also stimulates bile as well as the pancreatic juice secretion. Pepsinogen, it is secreted by chief cell or the peptic cell inside the lumen of the stomach. Pepsinogen is an inactive precursor of pepsin, and the pepsinogen, it is secreted by the chief cell, it is known as pepsinogen 1. And which is secreted by the pyloric glands, it is known as pepsinogen 2. Pepsinogen is synthesized and stored as zymogen granules. And pepsinogen secretion, it is stimulated by the vagal stimulation, gastrin, and the histamine. Pepsinogen, it is converted into the pepsin by the action of the hydrochloric acid. And pepsin, it also converts pepsinogen into the pepsin. And this is known as autocatalytic action of the pepsin. Pepsin is active form of the pepsinogen, and it is a proteolytic enzyme. It begins the process of the protein digestion. It splits protein into proteases, peptones, and polypeptides. Optimum pH for the action of the pepsin is 2, and pepsin produces curdling of the milk. Milk contains caseinogen, which is a soluble protein, and by the action of the pepsin, this soluble caseinogen, it is converted into casein. Casein can combine with calcium to form insoluble calcium caseinate, which is responsible for the curdling of the milk. And this action is performed by renin in small infants as well as the children. And because of this, rapid passage of the milk from the stomach to the duodenum, it is prevented. Secretion of stomach, they are of two type, exocrine secretion as well as the endocrine secretion. Exocrine secretion of the stomach is the gastric juice, and gastric juice, it is useful for the digestion of the food particles. And endocrine secretion of the stomach is gastrin. Gastrin, it is useful for the secretion of the hydrochloric acid, secretion of the gastric juice, as well as the movement of the stomach. Volume of the gastric juice is 2 to 2.5 liter per day. It is isotonic with plasma, and pH of the gastric juice is 1 to 2 because of the presence of the hydrochloric acid. Gastric juice, it contains 99.45% of water and 0.55% of the solids. Solids present in the gastric juice, they are of two type, organic solids and inorganic solids. Inorganic solids, these are the electrolytes like sodium, potassium, magnesium, chloride, bicarbonate, phosphate and sulfates. And organic solids, these are the various enzymes present in the gastric juice, mucus, as well as the intrinsic factor. Gastric juice contains various enzymes like pepsinogen. In the presence of the hydrochloric acid pepsinogen, it is converted into the active form pepsin, which is a proteolytic enzyme. Gelatinase, it liquefies gelatin, which is present in connective tissue. Gastric lipase, it is a weak fat splitting enzyme. Gastric amylase as well as the carbonic anhydrase, they are present in very small amounts. Lysozyme is the bactericidal in nature. Urease, it hydrolyzes urea to produce ammonia. And renin, it is present in the infants as well as in animals, which curdles milk and prevents rapid exit of the milk from the stomach. Mucin in the gastric juice, it is of two type, soluble mucin and insoluble or the visible mucin. Soluble mucus, it is secreted by the pyloric and cardiac glands, and insoluble mucus, it is secreted by the mucin secreting cells from the gastric mucosa. Mucus is alkaline in nature and gel-like consistency is present. It lubricates food and the gastric mucosa. Bicarbonates present inside the mucus, it forms mucosal bicarbonate barrier, which prevents damage to the gastric mucosa from the hydrochloric acid and the pepsin present inside the gastric juice. Intrinsic factor of the castle, it is secreted by the parietal cells of the gastric glands, which combines with the vitamin B12 and promote its absorption in the ileum of the small intestine. Deficiency of the intrinsic factor, which commonly occurs due to atrophy of the gastric mucosa, it promotes pernicious anemia because of the deficiency of vitamin B12. Gastric juice, it contains organic as well as the inorganic constituents. Organic constituents, these are the various enzymes, mucus and intrinsic factor. Enzymes like pepsinogen, gastric lipase, gelatinase, lysozyme, urease and the carbonic anhydrase, they are present in the gastric juice. Mucus, it is of two types, soluble mucus and visible mucus. And intrinsic factor of Castle, it is useful for the absorption of vitamin B12. Inorganic constituents, these are the various electrolytes like cations and anions present in the gastric juice. These cations, these are the hydrogen ions, sodium ions, magnesium and the potassium ions, they are present in the gastric juice. And anions, these are the chloride ions, bicarbonate, phosphate and sulfate ions, they are present in the gastric juice. Secretion of hydrochloric acid by parietal cells. This is a parietal cell. Parietal cells, they are present in the main gastric glands, which are present in the body of the stomach as well as in the fundus of the stomach. In the parietal cells, carbon dioxide and the water, in the presence of the enzyme carbonic anhydrase, they form H2CO3. This carbonic acid is a weak acid which rapidly dissociates into the hydrogen ions as well as the bicarbonates. Hydrogen ions, they are secreted in the lumen of the intracellular canaliculi in the exchange of the potassium. And this primary active transport, it is mediated by the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump. Various proton pump inhibitor drugs, for example omeprazole, it inhibits activity of the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump, and in this manner it decreases secretion of the hydrogen ions and decreases formation of HCl in the lumen of the stomach. Bicarbonate ions, they are transported by antiport in the basolateral membrane into the blood in the exchange of the chloride by an active transport. The bicarbonate released into the blood, it is responsible for the postprandial alkaline tide, which produces alkaline urine, slightly depressed breathing, and because of the decrease in the respiratory rate, it produces increase in the alveolar partial pressure of the carbon dioxide. Secretion of the hydrogen ion at the apical membrane and entry of the chloride ions inside the parietal cell at the basolateral membrane, it increases negativity inside the parietal cells. And this increase in the negativity, it opens chloride channels, and chloride ion, they enter inside the lumen of the intracellular canaliculi. And this flow of the chloride inside the intracellular canaliculi, it produces negativity inside the canaliculi. It combines with the hydrogen ions and forms hydrochloric acid. Factors promoting HCl secretion. First of all, the vagal stimulation, release of acetylcholine or the parasympathetic system. So the stimulation of the vagus nerve, it increases release of the acetylcholine at the postganglionic cholinergic neurons, and it acts on the M3 type of the muscarinic receptor, and it increases intracellular free calcium. Gastrin, it is released from the G cell of the pyloric glands, and gastrin, it binds with the gastrin receptor in the parietal cells, and it also increases release of the histamine from the enterochromaffin like cells, and it can increase intracellular free calcium. And this increase in the intracellular free calcium increases activity of the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump activity, and it can increase secretion of the HCl in the gastric lumen. Histamine can also increase hydrochloric acid secretion in the gastric lumen. The source of the histamine in the stomach are the enterochromaffin like cells which are present in the gastric mucosa. Various foodstuffs in our diet, they can increase histamine release. For example, meat and cabbage. This release histamine, it binds to H2 receptors in the parietal cells, and via stimulatory G protein, it increases adenylate cyclase activity and intracellular cyclic AMP, which increases hydrogen potassium ATPase pump activity, and in this manner, it can increase HCl secretion in the gastric lumen. So here we can see the factors affecting HCl secretion. factors that promote HCl secretion as well as the factors that inhibit HCl secretion. So the vagus nerve, acetylcholine, parasympathetic system, they all can increase HCl secretion. Histamine, which is secreted from the enterochromaffin-like cell, which can increase HCl secretion. And gastrin released from the G cell of the pylorus, it can increase HCl secretion. So vagus nerve, histamine and the gastrin, these are the factors that can increase HCl secretion. Now various factors that inhibit HCl secretion, mainly the low pH in the stomach, less than 3. By negative feedback mechanism, it inhibits hydrochloric acid secretion from the parietal cell in the stomach. Somatostatin, it inhibits release of the histamine as well as the gastrin. And prostaglandin E2, it acts via G1 receptors and decreases adenylate cyclase activity and the cyclic AMP. And in this manner, it decreases HCl secretion. So low pH, somatostatin as well as prostaglandin E2, they can decrease formation of the hydrochloric acid in the gastric lumen. In this figure, we can see mechanism of action of hormones on the parietal cell, the stimulation of the parietal cell as well as the inhibition of the parietal cell. Histamine, it acts on the H2 receptor and increases formation of the cyclic AMP. Gastrin acts on the gastrin receptor and through IP3-DAG pathway, it increases intracellular calcium. Acetylcholine, it acts on the M3 receptors and it increases intracellular calcium. Cyclic AMP as well as the calcium, it increases activity of the protein kinases, which increases hydrogen potassium ATPase pump activity, which can increase formation of the hydrochloric acid in the gastric lumen. Somatostatin inhibits formation of the cyclic AMP through the histamine as well as it decreases activity of the gastrin. Prostaglandin E2, it decreases formation of the cyclic AMP through the histamine. And in this manner, somatostatin and the prostaglandin E2, it decreases formation of the hydrochloric acid in the gastric lumen. Cephalic phase of gastric secretion, it is initiated by thought, sight, smell or taste of food and even thought of the food, which activates cerebral cortex and the hypothalamic centers and their influence on the dorsal motor nucleus of the vagus nerve. Vagus nerve is secretomotor to the stomach and it increases gastric secretion through cholinergic innervation to the parietal cell, peptic cell and enterochromaffin-like cell and non-cholinergic innervation to the G cell in the antrum of the stomach. This phase accounts for 40-50% of the total gastric secretion and this gastric secretion occurs even before the entry of the food into the stomach. Various emotions, they can also affect the gastric secretion through the vagus nerve. For example, anger and hostility, they increases gastric secretion and motility, and fear and depression, they decreases gastric secretion and motility. Now let us understand the direct as well as the indirect effect through which vagus nerve increases secretion of HCl in the stomach. Vagus nerve, by the direct cholinergic fibers on the parietal cell, it increases release of the acetylcholine at the neuronal endings that bind with the M3 receptor of the parietal cells. And by increase in the intracellular free calcium, it increases HCl secretion. Indirect effect is through the cholinergic neuron as well as the non-cholinergic fibers. Cholinergic neurons on the enterochromaffin-like cell, it increases release of the histamine. Histamine is a potent stimulator of the HCl secretion through the parietal cell. Histamine binds with the H2 receptor and it increases intracellular cyclic AMP, which can increase secretion of hydrochloric acid. In the second indirect effect, vagus nerve through the non-cholinergic fiber, it increases release of the gastrin-releasing peptide at the neuronal endings that binds with the gastrin-secreting cells, which increases release of the gastrin. Now gastrin, it can act on the enterochromaffin-like cell and increases release of the histamine. And the direct release of the gastrin, it acts on the gastrin receptors on the parietal cells that can increases intracellular free calcium and increases HCl secretion. So the vagus nerve, it can increase secretion of the HCl and it can also increase secretion of the pepsin by acting on the chief cell or the peptic cell, and it is known as vagal juice. In the patient with a peptic ulcer, atropine, it is not useful in the treatment because vagus nerve, through the direct cholinergic fiber as well as the indirect cholinergic fiber, it can increase gastric secretion through the release of the acetylcholine. And vagus nerve, it can also act by gastrin releasing peptide on the gastrin cell. It can increase HCl secretion. So whenever atropine is given, it inhibits cholinergic fibers, but the non-cholinergic fibers, they still can increase HCl secretion through the parietal cell. That's why atropine, it is not useful in the patient with a peptic ulcer. SAM feeding is the experimental setup to explain regulation of gastric secretion. So in the experimental animal, most commonly in the dog, after giving general anesthesia, a cannula is inserted inside the esophagus and a second cannula it is inserted inside the stomach of the animal to collect gastric juice. After the recovery, food is given to the animal. Now this food, it cannot reach up to the stomach because of the insertion of the cannula in the esophagus. But even after that, gastric juice, it is secreted from the stomach. It explains that a neural mechanism, it is involved in the secretion of the gastric juice. And this neural mechanism is via vagus nerve, that is secretomotor to the stomach. A second experiment by the Pavlov, and he demonstrated that the vagus nerve is secretomotor to stomach. So after giving general anesthesia, the pouch of the stomach, it is separated from the body of the stomach with the intact nerve and blood supply, and the pouch of the stomach, it is drained outside the abdominal wall. So a pouch is created with the intact nerve supply and the blood supply, and it is drained outside. After then, the vagus nerve is cut in neck, and after the recovery, the vagus nerve, it is stimulated, and the stimulation of the vagus nerve, it increases secretion of the gastric juice. So it shows that the vagus nerve, it is secretomotor to stomach. So Pavlov's experiment demonstrated the vagus nerve, it is secretomotor for the stomach, and it increases secretion of the gastric juice on stimulation. SAM feeding as well as the Pavlov's experiment, they explain the cephalic phase of the gastric secretion and the role of the neural mechanism in the regulation of the gastric secretion. But the head and hands experiment, it explained that other blood-borne mechanisms, they are also involved in the regulation of the gastric secretion. For this experiment, he has prepared a pouch of the enteral part of the stomach, and it is denervated, but it is with the intact blood supply. So blood supply is intact and nerve supply, it is removed. After the recovery, the distension of the pouch, it can increase gastric secretion. That demonstrates that other blood-borne mechanisms, they are also involved, because this pouch, it is denervated, and vagus nerve, it cannot increase gastric secretion from this pouch, but it is with the intact blood supply. So some blood-borne mechanisms, they are involved in the increase in the gastric secretion whenever this pouch is distended. So now we will understand about the gastric phase of the gastric secretion. Gastric phase of the gastric secretion starts when food arrives in the stomach, which produces distension of the stomach as well as the distension of the enterum, which activates vagovagal reflex, and through the cholinergic neuronal ending of the vagus nerve, it stimulates gastric secretion from the parietal cells of the stomach. Distension of the enterum as well as the presence of the partially digested protein products through the local reflex mechanism, it increases secretion of the gastrin from the G cell present in the pylorus as well as the enterum of the stomach. Gastrin enters inside the blood circulation, and then it reaches up to the parietal cells of the stomach and enterochromaffin like cells of the stomach, and it increases secretion of gastric juice. So in the gastric phase of the gastric secretion, neural mechanism involved is through vagovagal reflex and increased activity of the vagus nerve, and the chemical control mechanism through the release of the gastrin through the G cell in the pylorus of the stomach, they both increase gastric acid secretion, and this gastric phase accounts for 50-60% of the gastric secretion. Gastrin is the gastrointestinal hormone which is secreted from the G cells. G cells are also known as APUD cells, that is amine precursor uptake and the decarboxylation cell series, and they secrete gastrin. Gastrin, it is of three type: G14, G17 and G34, where G17 is the principal product. It is secreted in the inactive form progestin, and progestin it is converted into the gastrin by the action of HCl. Half-life of the gastrin is 2 to 3 minutes, and it is inactivated in the kidney as well as in the intestine. So from the G cells, gastrin it is secreted inside the bloodstream, and then gastrin it stimulates parietal cells as well as the enterochromaffin like cells. Functions of gastrin. Gastrin stimulates HCl secretion. Gastrin binds with the gastrin receptor present on the parietal cells of the stomach. These gastrin receptors, these are of CCK beta type, which can increase intracellular calcium through the IP3-DAG pathway. Increase in the intracellular calcium increases activity of the protein kinase C, which can increase activity of the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump. So more hydrogen ions are secreted into the lumen of the stomach, which can bind with the chloride to form HCl. So gastrin, it stimulates HCl secretion from the parietal cell of the stomach. Gastrin released from the G cell of the stomach can directly act on the parietal cell of the stomach to increase secretion of HCl. And gastrin also act on the enterochromaffin like cell to increase release of the histamine, and histamine binds with the H2 receptor on the parietal cell, and it can also increase HCl secretion. Gastrin increases gastric and intestinal motility. Gastrin also increases release of insulin and glucagon, and gastrin is necessary for proper growth of gastric mucosa. Factors affecting gastrin secretion. First of all, factors stimulating gastrin secretion. They are the vagal stimulation. Through the non-cholinergic vagal nerve fibers, they secrete gastrin-releasing peptide, which increases gastrin release. Distension of the pyloric enterum and product of the protein digestion. Through the local reflex mechanism, it increases gastrin secretion. Calcium and epinephrine can also increase gastrin secretion. Now, various factors that can inhibit gastrin release. These are the low pH of the gastric juice. By negative feedback mechanism, it decreases gastrin secretion from the enterum of the stomach. Somatostatin decreases gastrin release. Various gastrointestinal hormones like secretin, gastrin inhibitory peptide, vasoactive inhibitory peptide, they can also decrease gastrin secretion from the enterum of the stomach. Glucagon and the calcitonin can also decrease gastrin release. Intestinal phase of gastric acid regulation. It starts when chyme enters inside the duodenum. Now, intestinal phase, it produces two type of the effect, stimulatory as well as the inhibitory effect on the gastric acid secretion from the stomach. First of all, the stimulatory effect on the gastric acid secretion. When chyme enters inside the duodenum, it produces distension of the duodenum, which activates vagovagal reflex, and it increases stimulation of the duodenal endocrinal cells and increases secretion of the enterooxyntin. Now, both of these factors, they stimulate secretion of the hydrochloric acid from the parietal cells of the stomach in the initial phase. An inhibitory effect, it is because of the activation of the enterogastric reflex and release of various gastrointestinal hormones from the duodenum like secretin, gastrin inhibitory peptide, vasoactive inhibitory peptide, bulbogastrone and enteroglucagon. These are all the inhibitory factors and decreases secretion of HCl from the parietal cell of the stomach in the later phase. So intestinal phase, it is mainly inhibitory in nature. Now let us summarize phases of gastric acid secretion and their regulation. So gastric acid secretion, it occurs in three phases: cephalic phase, gastric phase and the intestinal phase. Cephalic phase, it is because of the thought of the food, smell and the taste of the food, and it occurs because of the neural mechanism, mainly through the vagus nerve. Gastric phase, it occurs because of the presence of the food inside the stomach, and it occurs because of the local neural secretory reflexes, vagal reflexes, as well as the secretion of the gastrin and histamine. Intestinal phase, it occurs because of the presence of the chyme in the intestine, and through various nervous mechanism as well as the hormonal mechanism, it increases gastric acid secretion initially, followed by decrease in the gastric acid secretion through the enterogastric reflex as well as various gastrointestinal hormones.